Welcome, everybody. This is day 211, Make It Songbringer. And today I'm going to be working on more story elements. Here we are in the first cave where you get the sword. And now I want the player to say some stuff inside here, like, I don't know, something funny. And then he'll pick up the sword and say something else funny. And yeah, all that running from the story elements and, yeah, then I'm also going to need to test it out with the existing dialogue on the first screen. Just make sure everything works, you know. So yeah, basically I'm working on the story some more today. Let's create some text for the player to say down there. There's two ways I could trigger this. One, if the player's at a certain Z, I guess that would work right now without having to upgrade any systems or anything. But that does mean that I'm tying sword Z is negative 10. That does mean I'm tying it to that. So if we're in the if we're at the swords cave. What up, Mummier? How you doing today? And we don't have the sword. We'll say something. Dialogue's implied. What up, Peter? Alessandro, I got a question for you. I was wondering if you happen to remember the world seed you used when you had your bug where you had no sword. Arcane, what's up, man? Yeah, I figured out the missing cars. Actually, I got really deep into that thing. It took me the rest of the night. And then I just finally this morning I'm like, you know what, screw this. I redid everything by using by recreating. So basically the problem was different every time I ran it, which was really weird, right? And so eventually, instead of storing the label and reusing it within the dialogue component, so that was the way I originally designed it, is that the dialogue component would hold the a label. So basically reusing labels is really problematic. I don't know why. There's got to be some bug in Cocos 2DX or whatever, but I just said screw it, and I every time it creates some new dialogue, it creates a new label. So that works. Yeah, I'm good, man. Hello, what's up? Did I say Sivan? Is that right? Oh, okay, cool. Cool. I hope we get that. All right, so yeah, let's get some dialogue for him to say when he's like, when he's just about to get the sword. Really? Save on. All right. Well, cool. Oh, sorry guys, that might have been real loud. Yeah, I was talking about this. Developing it So, Savon, developing it, I did the very first week. So if you look at like days 1 through 7, and then I actually went at a lot of people's requests, I went through and talked a lot about how it works on one of the videos. Let me see if I can find it. I know I discussed it on the Kogos 2DX forum. And it was somewhere in here. Maybe, yeah, Songbringer discussion and here we go. You go. There's that one too. That this is where I really talk about it in detail. And then of course you can get it all on GitHub. It's all there on GitHub, so I'm sure you already know that if you're asking about it. Ah. Right on, right on. Yeah, I didn't see the Apple keynote, but I saw some of those. I saw some of their page today. Thank you, Alex Pita. Awesome, man. Okay, now I have what I need to test this out and make sure that that world isn't the thing that's creating the no sword issue you had. Yeah, totally, right? It's growing really fast on Twitch. I wish it would grow this fast on Twitter too. Yeah, of course, man. So yeah, we'll get him to say some funny, witty stuff here when he picks up the sword. Let's do a sword 1 and 1A, like that and that. Okay. I'm breaking in and out. Doesn't look like it's dropping frames. Right, so we'll do. All right, you'll need another story entity as well for this after he picks up the sword. So we got sword 2. If we don't have the sword, yeah, we already did this. Okay. Well, I have no clue about that. So I don't know how Twitch does their internal stuff. Oh, maybe that's a good idea, Mom. You're right. Maybe I should start doing that. So, sword 2, I want him to say something like, yeah, thanks, Speedy Flip. Yeah, It's also really helping this scene right here. Okay, so let's see if he does that dialogue. All right, well, he's not doing this one. Huh. We got sword, or story, sword one. What's up, bulldozer? Yeah, I use Cocos 2DX, man. It's a great game library, game engine. It could be nice if Jib learns our language. There you go, bulldozer. That's what I use, man. It's a great engine. It's open source. It's cross-platform. That's probably the most important thing, I think, for any game engine, is it for it to be cross-platform. It's critical these days. All right, we've got no story elements, so it shouldn't have any problem doing that. Yeah, of course. You're welcome, man. Why is it not triggering? Z better not be unsigned. That's a good one. So it's one of these two things. It's either the Z or... Oh, that one should be has sword. Maybe it was that. Maybe it tried to run one before the other one. No, it's just not triggering either of those. Thank you. Yodov. Thanks, man. Okay, so I'll just do a little divide and conquer thing here. We'll start without the Z. Maybe it's that, or maybe it's the not sword. So it was the Z. All right, so there's obviously some kind of problem with Z being, or Z requirement of negative 10. I'm guessing maybe it's unsigned. So I'm going to go back to the story system where it parses the story, all the story nodes, and it's going to parse Z. Oh, it does that in actually world matcher. Oh, wow. So I kind of did something really stupid with that. Or I can make this parse vector smarter. So what's going on here, what the problem was, is that I used the minus sign to denote a range of Z. So essentially this is like I would usually use Z of like, I don't know, 0 through 10. But because I'm using just minus 10, that's what's causing this problem right here. So I've got to figure that out. What's up, Arcor? It's going good, man. I'm working on story elements today. I'm in the room where the player gets the sword, and I'm working on some story elements here. So I think the thing to do here is to make the parse vector either parse on Dang, the range. This is such a good indicator for range, but it totally disables the use of minus. Oh, what to do? Oh, you know what? I got it. Let's make this smarter right here. So if the very first character is a minus, then it'll just parse out one number because minus z's are always going to be not ranges. Cool, that'll work. So if str 0 equals minus, then z min equals z max equals str 2l str dot c str. There, so we can keep the ranges. Oh, look at this. We can have our cake and eat it too. Yay. Wait, but let's make sure the story actually got. Yeah, okay, story's good. So I'm noticing right here, the screen is getting really wobbly because the random shake right here is using floating point numbers, and now that we're using this pixel perfect stuff. Yeah, nice. He did both lines. Yeah, right on. Okay, that worked well. Yeah, I also want to take the light beams and make them. Actually, I'm going to think about putting the light beams on top of the frame buffer so that the light beams can actually be super high quality. So that's in flux where it does the flux for. Lifting the sword? Yeah, lifting the sword. Man, my brain's slow today. I don't know why. I still have not figured that out. I don't know why some days I got energy, some days I don't. Today's one of those ones I don't. So pardon me if my code is crazy today. So here we go. We're lifting the sword. I don't Oh yeah, where it goes and animates all this. There's a little bit where it shakes. And this is just passing in new camera pause and all that, so I might as well make this work for every flux I ever write. So I'm gonna go into the animate method where it's gonna go and run. There's where it runs the current phase's animate. After that, it moves the camera. Here's where we wanna put the camera's pause. Clamp it to an integers. So camera pause dot x equals round f. See if that works. So when it starts to shake the screen, it won't look so jello-y. Oh, it saved my game with the sword. So we want to disable having the sword, and we want to make sure. Yeah, let's do both those. All right, good. So that time it didn't shake as much because obviously that one integer, right? Thanks, man. Thank you. Thanks for saying that. It's good to know. It's good to know that I'm still okay in your eyes, even though I'm slow today. Makes me feel a little more relaxed. So yeah, I think I want it to actually shake a little more now, maybe. Now that it's clamped to integers, and integers can be pretty small. I mean, it can be actually pretty big, depending on how many pixels you have on your screen. Oh, thanks, Speedy Flip. Man, I really appreciate that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, cool. As soon as I get your email address and everything, I'll write you. I gotta write actually everybody that's donated already. So you can get your name in the credits and on the main menu. You'll be part of the backers list here. So, yeah. Thanks, man. So let's try a shake of 2.0 this time. Whoops. Keeps saving the sword every time. Yeah, this is a full-time gig for sure. It started off full-time. I just made it as much as I could, with the funds I had, and I spent those first 4 months developing this game and kind of preparing to do a Kickstarter. So, yeah, after 4 months, I launched the Kickstarter and was able to get the funds to be able to keep doing this full-time. Yeah, it's definitely a lot of work. I know I only stream for 2 hours a day, but I definitely work for about 8 to 10 every day, and that's like 6 to 7 days a week. So I'm a one-man team, and that's kind of it's a huge benefit, and it's also a drawback. It's a benefit, and then I can do whatever I want, and I can do it as fast as I can, things like that. But that's still also a limitation, is I can only do it as fast as I can. And making every bit of games takes a lot of time, from making the art to making the music to writing the code. Every bit of it is a lot. It's very time consuming. So I just work longer. I'm like Amish. What's up, Mike? Yo, man, how are you doing today? That was maybe a little bit too much, actually. Let's do 1.618. And the next thing I want to do is make it so when the camera is zoomed, I want it to. Yeah, that too. Yeah, that's actually really awesome. What's up, professional novice? Yo, man. That's also true. Yeah. So you kind of have to just be a big doer to do something like this. Yeah, I'm working on the actual story system. I'm noticing with this new frame buffer technique to do the pixel perfect shadows and all that, there's some refinements I need to make to the camera. Oh, Jacko Gamer, that's a cool thought. I mean, it does get more intense throughout that flux already though. It starts at a really low level and builds up, and then it builds back down. So the camera shake though in general, maybe I can apply that technique to it. Like when you hit enemies and stuff. But the next thing I want to do is make it so when it zooms the camera, it does so on like an integer basis. So the height, the layer gets scaled. Man, this might be some really complex math. I'm not sure if I could do this right now. But basically, I would make it so the Z, a certain. So what happens right now is when you zoom the camera in, it gives you a height factor, first of all, which is like. Or if it's less than one. So yeah, this is the one we need to look at. If it's. So if you get a height of like 0.0, is 0.5. That's twice as of one. The height is 0.5. That means zoom in twice as much. So twice as much would be half the pixels. So we need to do some math here. I know we're at least going to need the frame buffer size. Let's do a float scale. Scale is going to be approximately this, but we want this to kind of round to so that it's not the integers comes out so that every pixel is exact, so it doesn't zoom any more than a single pixel at once. What up, True Sandwich? Thanks, man. So I know we're going to need the actual frame buffer size. And so yeah, I was just saying if we're at 0 point or if we're at scale of 2.0, that's half the pixels. Okay, so we want to take the size dot width. Yeah, okay. So we go size dot width equals or times equals h, really, that's all there is to it. So yeah, the size dot width is going to be multiplied by the camera height factor. So if the height factor is 0.5, it's going to be a size dot width of 120 or whatever. And then we just L round it. Or yeah, no, just round F. Round F H times size dot width. There. So that gives us an actual pixel size of the screen that we want it to exactly be. Oh, that's so funny. Oh man. Took 40 minutes to compile that. You haven't even tried running it? Oh, that's funny. And then we need to convert it back. So now that we, oh wait, we want this to be we'll do float W equals. So yeah, we need, and then so the scale be out comes out to be. Scale is W over size dot width. I think. Let's just try running it first. See if it's that's even right. Because I would normally set a breakpoint here, but I'm hoping that is all correct math at first and it will just magically work. What are the chances that it will magically work? Probably pretty low. Oh, whoops, backwards. Okay, well, let's try that the other way around. So the scale is going to be size dot width over w. I can't tell if that worked or not. Let's make that zoom in last forever. And then we'll be able to tell pretty easily whether it's working or not. So the flux. Where does it kick off this whole lift the sword flux? It goes. It zooms in while you're walking, I think. Yeah, I think it's walk to. This is something I need to make more data driven. All these classes really are just screaming to be data driven. Yeah, here it is. So, transition duration. Let's make this instead of being 0.7, we'll make it 7.7 seconds. So that's going to take forever for it to zoom in. And we'll see if that actually works, if it zooms in nice and 1 pixel at a time. We just want 1 pixel at a time. Yeah, no, I don't think it's working. Because we're getting a lot. Yeah. Okay, let's go back to lens and see what's happening with all this math each time. All right, so to start it off, we got an H of 0.9999957774. So we're getting the size of the frame buffer. H times the size rounded becomes the exact same size. All right, this is one of those things where we'd actually need to log this out because we need to see it happen over time without pausing the time. So we'll log the H. The W. And the ultimate scale. See what these numbers are coming out like. Corleone, now this is C++. Yep. C++ 14 to be exact, but there's not really that many differences between 14 and 11 that I'm using yet. Here we go. So we got a zoom in height of still close to 1. We got a scaled width of 419, 418. Yeah, these widths are good, but maybe it's just the fact that Maybe I actually need to do heights. I was just thinking about that because the height is less than the width. So that might be it. So let's call this scaled height equals h times size dot height. Did it work? Do you have to recompile already? Oh, it's working? Oh, thank the good Lord above. Right on, man. Well, you're never too late to learn, man. You can, despite what other people might tell you can learn anything at any age you are. That's not working either. It's like really jittery. Maybe the scale's correct, but the width and the height aren't. Huh. Yeah, I'm not sure why this is working. It's true. You don't need school. Yeah, so what I was saying there is there's really just no need to be jealous. You're just on a different time window as me, you know? I started learning earlier. You're starting later, but that doesn't matter. Ultimately, it's up to you to learn it and, gain the skills that you want to create, you know? And it does really, and what time I'm at, what progress level I'm at compared to what progress level you're at is completely irrelevant. Well, in theory, this should be correct, but oh, and another thing, the height and the width shouldn't be clamped here. They should be clamped here. So this should work for everything, any type of lens effect at all. Jip started talking in the middle of that scene there. That was funny. Oh no, it's running this one. Oh man, that still didn't work. I wonder if there's some other, you know what, I should probably table this for later. Thanks, man. Right on. Well, good for you, man. That's some progress right there. Yeah, I don't know what to do about this right now, so I'm gonna table this for later and move on to some things that I can actionably do right now. What's up, Grim Gary? Welcome to the stream today. Right on, cool, man, me too. I love my Mac, I love my Unix. All right, let's move on to the next stuff then. We've got two story elements that are working there. Oh, I don't want to play overworld music in this flux. And let's move back to not using the 7 seconds for zooming in. Nice. It's true. Motivation is pretty important to learning. If you're not motivated to learn, you just ain't gonna do it. So let's see if combining all those things together works okay, even though I guess we could make it so it locks the player's input when he's talking in this one story element here. So we would go input lock dialogue input unlock. See if this works. True. Oh my god. Windows can really slow you down, I think. But I mean, it depends on your... Depends on what you prefer. Personally, for me, Windows can really slow me down because it's just got so many little bugs in the system. Okay, let's do that again. I want to change that line a little bit. I didn't do a second dialogue line. Oh, because it's during a flux. You can't do anything with the dialogue element during a flux. Damn. Yeah? Yeah, the shadows are pixeled. Yeah. Wait, was it, you mean during that transition? Wait, this should have worked. Later on. Oh, man. Okay, we got several bugs to fix here. Okay, let me write both these down so I don't forget any of this. Okay, so I can just up the letter duration. What's up, blood? And to get the I'm wondering what the heck was going wrong with this new story, adding this stuff to the story element, the input lock, run the dialogue, input unlock. Wait, so if I just, let's see, if I just take that away, see if it works now. Oh, he already has a sword. Oh, man. Well, it's based on how many letters there are. So if your translation in Italian is long in Italian, it's going to still be longer that way. Is that what you mean? I just increased the time. Let's see if it worked to make it a little better. Yeah, the shadows are fine, I think. Here, I'll take a screenshot. And then I'll run it again with disabling the FBO so we can see if there's any difference between those. He should move his hand when he talks in Italian. Oh, I could make that happen. I could give him an animation. Wow, this is kind of interesting to see the game running at without the FBO technique. Oh, good. Right on. Thanks, Horland. Yes. Yeah, it's a one-man thing. But I got you guys. It's not technically a one-man thing when I got you guys to help out with suggestions and ideas and stuff. Look at all these ideas that came from people. right, so let's compare those. Yeah, these are fine. So there's one, that's 1 pixel, or what equates to 1 pixel, and then there's the shadows are 1 pixel. And then here's the with the FBO, you can clearly tell there's 1 pixel, and then there's the fuzzy shadow. So yeah. It's fine. It's all good. The shadows are totally pixel. Nice, right on. Okay, good. Well, yeah, there's those two bugs are definitely not bugs. Thing is, I don't want. Maybe scene transitions. I don't if like for example Jib starts talking or he's got some scheduled dialogue and then you go off the screen, he still says his dialogue. I kind of think if you walk upstairs or downstairs. Maybe. Yeah, it's probably because it was zoomed in. It probably just looked a little bit different. But yeah, it's all good. Oh, also, yeah, when it's doing these fluxes and whatever, or I mean, when it's doing that, all these lens effects. Only if we're only if we're doing the FBO, should we do this technique to round the scaled height. Right, so if we are doing FBO round the scaled height. And we'll do the same kind of thing here. So we only clamp the camera's position if we're doing the FBO technique. Yeah, I think that's the right way to do it. Okay, and I'm definitely going to touch on this later. All right, so let's make a way to cancel any running dialogue. I think all we would have to do is, yeah, stop any actions that are running on the dialogues layer, because that really does everything. Also the fade. Yeah, so we need to cancel any actions on the layer and the sprite. All right, so let's make a function to do that. We'll make it in the dialogue. I guess we'll put it as part of the story system. It's part of the dialogue anyway. So make a static, void, cancel all dialogue. All right. And then in the story system, we'll loop over all ids. Man, it would be so great if I had autocomplete. But I've noticed lately Xcode, when you're compiling, it doesn't do autocomplete. It's like it used to, I think. Get all dialogue components. Is void like a function? No, it's not a function. It's a type. Yeah, this is implied. Function, the word function is implied here. Right? But void is the return type. It's returning nothing. If I had int right there, int something, 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 blah, blah, that would return an int. See what I mean? So the void just means that you're returning nothing from this function. And really what denotes a function C++ or C is that you've got these parentheses after the name of the function. Right on, man. I'm so glad you fixed a 2-year-old thing. That's rad. Right? Yeah. Are you even coding in PHP or something? Thanks for making me laugh. Oh yeah, I know what you mean. I've been a web developer too, so I've definitely had those moments where I've been coding mostly in PHP or JavaScript, and then come back to C++, and I'm like, whoa, you gotta like, it's like a context switch really quick, you know? Layer, okay, so here we go. Layer, stop all actions. Dialogue. Sprite, stop all actions. There, this cancels all dialogue. Should cancel all dialogue, let's see. And then, okay, we'll do this when we're doing any walking upstairs or downstairs or elevating. I would do when you're fluxing from screen to screen, but I kind of like the fact that you can walk off screen and he's still keeps talking. So I'm not gonna do that flux, but all the other fluxes, we'll do that. Here's one, elevator up. Story system. Cancel all dialogue. Elevator down. Actually, no, let's not even do it here on the elevate just yet. Because there might be some times where we do want to continue talking. Nah. Decisions. I think I'll do this, yeah, for these four fluxes. I might have a faulty design here when I'm doing this four times. Fade in, fade out. There we go, upstairs. All right. Oh. I hear you, Momir, for sure. It drives you crazy, especially if you've started off your programming career with something like C or C++, where everything is strongly typed, and most of the time what you write happens, you know? So, okay, what we're gonna do here is after he picks up the sword, he's gonna say a line of dialogue, and so is Jib. I'm gonna run off the screen as fast as I can so that it triggers that flux. And we'll just make sure that he doesn't. Oh, he's. Oh, man. One more thing, the story, it shouldn't do this home zero. If you have the sword. Oh wow, El Capitan coming out. Right on. I like that you can hide the dock, or you can hide the bar or whatever that is finally. Yeah, the keynote's been off today, right? Homestar Runner. The email. The email. What's Edge? I haven't even heard of the Edge. Geocities, right? What's up, Mighty Nest? There really a browser called Edge? I haven't even heard of it. Microsoft? Should I even look at it? Oh, it's the Windows 10 browser. So it's like internet, it's just Internet Explorer. It's the latest version of Explorer. Is it really any different? Yo, man. Okay, what next? Yeah, I guess we gotta debug and figure out why it didn't trigger that whole stopping the dialogue thing. Or maybe it did trigger it. And that just didn't. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. So, yeah, we'll just loop over all these after we set this breakpoint. Links! Yes! Oh, I love links. Do I have links? I think I do. Yes, I do. What would be a funny thing to go to links on? Giphy? Oh wow, there's actually lots of things on Giphy. Oh, I'm using Vim keys. It's better, but still. Oh, it is different then? Okay, cool. It's fast? It's finally fast? Is it like accurate and stuff? Wait, is it still based on. Okay, here's the biggest question. Is it still based on Microsoft's version of the browser, or did they finally use something like Mozilla or some other better thing so that we don't have to have code for IE, code for Chrome? Oh, use its own render? Hmm. we gotta do this again, turn that off. Oh, they don't use WebKit? So they're still using their own proprietary thing? Damn them. This is not good for web developers. Oh, it didn't get called. Oh, now it gets called? After all that? Oh, I guess fade out, fade in. Oh. ActiveX. Okay, well, that's the problem. It was calling the upstairs, but it really should have done it on fade out. Thanks, Corleon. Yeah, so in here, downstairs, upstairs, all of these, really. Yeah, thankfully, I got a better design. Yay. So fade out. Or even just fade in. Fade in would be a perfect one to do it on. Yeah, okay, and then let's find the other places where we're doing cancel all dialogue. Like elevator up. We don't want to start it on elevator up, we want to start it on the flux. Yeah, here we go. Okay, once again, let's try this one more time. Try and get the dialogue to cancel. In fact, with this breakpoint here, I guess we do need the breakpoint. Oh, you know what? I could just have him start talking and then I could run out the room and it'd be the same thing. Oh man, come on. Why didn't it do it? Oh. Maybe it did. Let's try that again. One of those days, one of those days. Oh, it needs to be fade out. But anyways, let's see what's up here. Dialogue component. It's good. Whoa. Maybe because she was in Aliens? Oh, yeah. Okay, so this does need to be fade out and fade in. And so we're primarily running we could even cancel those talking M's there. I No longer need this is jib. But is there anywhere else that runs an action that needs to be stopped? Dialog.layer, dialog.sprite, dialog.layer. It should work fine. Okay, one more thing. These also need to be set to opacity 0 so they're invisible. Oh, actually, man, these should just be invisible completely. I know, so much debugging, right? Just for one little thing. Oh, I'm kind of exasperated today a little bit. Exasperated with debugging. So let's start doing this the right way. It should be set visible false. Instead of opacity 0. And then in enims. Whoa, that's as tall as I am. Man, she's giant. Oh, and also, yeah, so then we go show or hide. I think it's just hide. Hide create. Yeah, so we want to do show create and a hide create. Okay, first we want to make sure the two pieces of dialogue do run. This will speed the game up a little bit, being able to hide these and show these things so they won't be visible all the time. Even something visible at zero opacity does cause a GL draw call. So, all right, that worked. Good. I'm glad. Nice, man. You're giant. Oh, it worked! It finally worked! So technically this story should have home 0 and home 1 at this point. Yeah, finally it worked, right? Oh man. Okay, so let's see all this in action, right? I mean, he still does that dialogue. I guess we should cancel all dialogues when we do the lift sword action, too. Yeah, let's do that. Flux. It does. Nice. Yeah, this is probably the most 8-bit of all the tracks so far. It's really, I mean, it's not really a track. It's only 15 seconds or whatever, but. Cool. That time, he did not do a second dialogue line. What happened there? That was weird. All right, cool. Well, yeah, that works. It works. Does the sword have a name? No. Doesn't have a name. It's called the Nano Sword at this point. Probably should have a name though, and it should talk. Right on. I like chiptunes too. All right, and so that should work with the home screen too. So if we run, if we start off the whole game. Let's kill the sword, kill everything. Let's see this all in order. So I fixed it so the player cannot move right here. So that's cool. You can't move until he actually stands up. So if I go down the stairs now, it should cancel all this dialogue. Yeah, good. Oh, but it's not doing his dialogue here. Why not? Oh, man. The sword's name should be Gary. Yeah, I do have a release date. I only have so much funds from the Kickstarter, so I have to release at a certain point. I would love to be able to just have the luxury of releasing when it's ready, but I don't have that luxury. So I have to release it sometime between January and March. Probably January. If I can get more funds from people pre-ordering, then I can release it in March with it being a little bit higher quality at its first release. But regardless of what day or month or what I release it in, I'm going to keep increasingly making it better. I'm going to release free updates, just free updates, everything, especially with a lot of these ideas. There's a lot of these ideas here. I might not be able to have time to get to some of these by the time I first release it, but I can at least put in stubs in the data and everything so that I can add these without affecting the world's needs too much. Thanks, Jen. Thank you, man. Am I happy with the progress? Oh, man, that's a hard thing to answer. I mean, I wish I would be happier if I had made more progress, I guess. But I guess in general, this is actually really a lot of progress for one person to be able to do. Especially doing a Kickstarter and already having its greenlit on Steam and everything. I mean, yeah, I guess I am happy. But I wish it was farther. But still, I'm going to be working on this game for another year and a half. So once it comes out in January, well, that's assuming it does well on the Steam release. So the Steam release will give me the funds to be able to continue porting it to other platforms, or else it won't, and then I'll have to get a job and it'll take longer. But anyways, the plan is for the Steam release in January to March or whatever, and then just keep working on the game for another 6 months to a year, porting it to more platforms and doing all these rad ideas that I would love to do. What do I need to pay for the release? I don't need to personally pay anything, because you already have to pay your Steam fee before you do Greenlight. So it costs you $100. It wasn't 90, but it was 100 for me at least. But yeah, you have to pay $100, and that allows you the right to even try Greenlight. So you have to pay that first. Corlian, the Kickstarter is already over. Yeah, but if you do want to still support the project and be a backer, you get your name on the main menu. And you can do that by pre-ordering at songbringer.com. So there's songbringer.com. It's got all the info on pre-ordering or whatever. And yeah, and that basically gets you your name on the main menu as an honorary backer. So let me show you what it looks like. Oh, I can't run anything until I stand up. Here, I'll just turn off skip menu really quick. So yeah, here on the main menu, all the backers' names are thanked. So by pre-ordering, you get your name thanked there. And it also helps me to make the game better before it actually is first released. So yeah, right. Thanks. Yeah, from an outside perspective, that's really helpful for you to say that, man. Thank you. Yeah, I think anybody would wish they were further, right? Thanks, man. Okay, so yeah, when I ran that dialogue there, we had a few more issues. It just didn't run the dialogue for when he first. So what if I start again in 0, 0, -10? Right on. Now he does the dialogue. Oh, what if it's canceling the dialogue because it ran it all? Oh. Yeah, that might be it. Okay, let's try that theory. Flux, when it fades in. So fade out, but not fade in. Okay, let's see if that works. Jen, yeah, I'll give you two really important keys to learning how to make games. First of all, there's a great video series you should start checking out. Let me give you the link to that. This is by Extra Credits. You've probably seen a few of their videos already, but this is a playlist for all of their game development videos. And all of these are like critical. They're amazing videos, and they're just like so apropos to how to make games. And I can't believe I haven't liked this video. Yeah, so check all of these out. Make this like... Check out like one of these videos a day and start with this one right here, Making Your First Game, The Basics. And then my recommendation is to go, I'm not sure what they use. I think when they're talking about these videos, they are talking, they don't specifically recommend using A certain game engine? No, I don't think so. But yeah, when you're looking, when you're now, when you when you're going to start out, like go find a game engine that you like, you know. But I, you know what? These videos will tell you everything about that. And this is the other thing that I would say. This is my personal advice, is like follow your heart, and that is with. It helps in so many different ways. I really am going to write a whole blog post just about this topic, because this will help you get, it will help you get things finished. Because if you're actually doing things because you want to, because your heart says you to, because you're passionate about it, because you're excited about it, you will actually finish things. You will be more excited during the process. You'll have more fun during the process. You'll produce content or games or whatever you create, even if it's the smallest thing in the world. You'll create it. If you create it with your heart, you create something that's just more awesome. So follow your heart and check out those videos. Yeah, definitely. They're not talking in about just Unity. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Yeah, Unity is a great one to start with too. Yeah, I highly recommend Unity, Game Maker, Construct. Yeah, all those, they're great places to start and feel out if that's the kind of engine that you'd like. Right, so let's see if that actually fixed it. Yeah, right on. Yoshi catches apples. Sweet. Did you rip the old sprite sheet of Yoshi, or did you make your own Yoshi? All right, come on, let's see this all work in series. Okay, so I'm going downstairs to cancel that dialogue, but still. Oh! Damn it all to hell! Oh, these little bugs, man. He's not doing his dialogue right here. Yeah, that's a thought. Good thought, Momir. Nice. Pygame is another great recommendation for an engine to start with, because Python is a great language to learn when you're first learning a programming language. Python is actually pretty good, unless you're just super dedicated and you're like, you know, you want to be a programmer. Then I would recommend C, personally. All right, why does it not trigger this story? Or maybe it does trigger the story, and it's canceling it. All right, let's narrow that down by we'll set a log statement when it triggers a story element, and then we'll set another log statement. There, so this will kind of like allow the timing to play out exactly as it does, but we'll have some log statements to see if this is what's causing that issue. So canceling all dialogue. Yeah. In fact, this is probably what I would recommend to the ultimate beginner, as you know, if everyone was the same, you know, I would recommend this to everyone. But in general, like, or to the individual person, that's why I recommend checking out all the engines first, because then, you know, you might be more attracted to Unity or whatever. Maybe Pygame is just not their speed, you know, for some people. But I guess in general, I would definitely recommend this. Pygame plus learn Python the hard way. Okay, we're all good to try this out. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, there's not so many weird characters, and you don't, yeah, you're, just everything, braces and all that stuff. It's a very simple language, but it's also, what's great about it is it's sort of C-like, you know? Same sort of scoping, same, yeah. Once you get used to it, you can kind of, it's an easy step to go from there to languages which do have all those weird characters. All right, let's see what happened. Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, I thought Pygame at least had some of the basic stuffs, like, can it at least load like a ping file or an image? Can it at least load an image and play a sound? See, it's not even triggering the dialogue. Well, that explains it. Oh, wait, here it is. Triggering dialogue home 1A. Yeah, I think so. Ah, good. Well, cool. At least a beginner doesn't have to redo all that stuff. That's not beginner friendly stuff. So yeah, we got home 1A, canceling all dialogue, and then it never runs the other one. Why does it not run it? Okay, let's do this. If we have home 1 and home 1A, we've already done those, and we run straight downstairs. Is it gonna say his line that time? Yeah, definitely. Yeah, well, maybe I think Python would be a little bit more friendly to learn than Java. Skip menu, we want that to be one. Yeah. Oh, whoops. This is supposed to be home 0. All right, cool. Oh, he doesn't. What? Yeah, it is procedural, I'm pretty sure. You can do functions, I mean. Okay, so if I start at z negative 10, it works, but if I don't start at z negative 10, it doesn't work. What's with that, man? So weird. It's true. Okay, let's fix this bug. This bug is close. What's up, Mars of Power? What language do you speak? Yeah, definitely. Okay, so for some reason, this is not triggering if we walk downstairs. Probably because when it starts. I have no idea why. Oh, Norwegian. All right. Okay, let's get this, let's dial this in, figure out what's going on with this. Oh, in fact, let's do this. Let's narrow down the entire story system. Gonna save a little backup of this. And we're just gonna have Sword One in the dialogue system, and let's see if that actually fixes it to start with. No. Okay, good. Yeah, it's true. Oh, that's crazy. Oh, right on. Good. Huh. Well, you, Corlian, you might want to try out the Unreal Engine. I know it's kind of advanced, but it's very graphical. Like you can hook things up and do all this stuff with diagrams and stuff. So if you're a graphic designer, maybe Unreal is your speed. You might want to try it out. I think it's free or something. I think both on Unity and Unreal are free now. Right. Okay. Why does it not trigger this? Do we have the sword? Is that why? No, we don't have the sword. So this should work. It should work fine. Why? Okay, we'll set a breakpoint. If the current P pause equals pause 0 0 negative 10. Yeah, I hope that helps. What's CryEngine? Is that sort of like a visual thing? Oh my God, this looks beautiful. Holy crap. Yeah. I want to go to that place. Did you see the movie Ex Machina? I think they claimed that it was filmed in Norway or whatever. That place was so beautiful. Ah. Cool. Wow. Haven't seen this engine yet. Whoa, Daniele. Dude, your picks are sweet. Beautiful. So crisp. Nice, man. Wow. How come I haven't even heard of this engine? I'm pretty sure it was, right? Do you know where it was filmed though in Norway? 'Cause man, I want to go there. There's no bread, right? Yeah, what's up with that? Yeah, totally. I loved it too. I was like, oh, I think I liked it a little more than my girlfriend did. Wait, it's now available on Steam, meaning you can just. Wow. Sort of. It's a live streaming movie? No, it's way better than that. Why doesn't this story know? Trigger. Oh, this is now longer. There's no pause. So V1, V3I. Whoa. That's crazy. It didn't even trigger this. What is the issue? Oh, yeah, of course, of course. Yeah, post links all you want, man. I know it, right? Yeah, in any kind of TV series or whatever, or movie. It's a Unix system. Okay, we've got the breakpoint working this time. What's this? What's the swatting thing? Hello, Sawa. Welcome. Did I what was I supposed to hear about the Apple TV? I haven't really heard about it, no. Oh, sweet. Thank you, Corlean. Wow, you can even visit there? Oh, man. Oh, it's a hotel. So sweet. Oh my God, cool. I'm gonna check this out later on. Songbringer reach our flat panels? You mean Apple TVs? Oh, I don't know. Maybe we'll see. I didn't know they had a whole Reddit about it's a Unix system. Reddit. Wow, cool. Ah, right on. Really? Oh, wow. All right, so it must be the timer, right? If timer is greater than zero, no, it's not the timer. Oh, characters have to be within margin. Oh my God, is that all it is? Oh. Okay, that's all it was. So, okay, margin, let's mix up these margin things. I looked on their site and they still have it today. Right? But his name is Epimetheus. He's named after the god of afterthought. Whitey. Okay, so the. Let's make this YP instead. So YP is going to be your position dot Y over the area size dot height. And if the Y percent is less than 1.0 minus margin, we should be all good to go to play any sort of dialogue. So that means if the player is standing, on the bottom of the screen, it should be able to play dialogue. If the player is standing all the way on the right side of the screen, they need to come in a little bit. Same thing with the left side, they need to come in a little bit. Same thing with the top, they need to come down. So, yeah, so that'll improve the margins. So basically now, if I walk down here, it should play this dialogue. Come on. Play it. You know you want to play it. Oh, man. What did I do wrong this time? The pencil actually looks pretty cool. What? Yeah, Mars Power knows this for every day. What? That's so funny. Yeah, that'd be so funny. Right. What's up, Fong? Oh my God. Okay, yeah. Let's do that in certain Easter egg worlds. I love that idea. I know, right? It's their own fault, though. Oh. This is supposed to be greater than or equal to. Duh. In fact, I bet this should be margin times two. Nah, let's leave it as margin for now. Okay, come on. Work with me. Work with me. Work on the first try. Works so good that I can run the whole story element for the beginning and it all works fine. You know you want to, game. Come on, game. Get your head together, game. Get in the game, game. Yes. Oh, it's about freaking time. All right, let's see if it all can work now. If I do all these, every story element at the beginning of the game. What? Oh no. Now it's not doing the very first one. Oh, what did I do? Oh, duh, because I took out the whole story to run these tests. Okay, no problem. No problem. Bam. Let's see that again. Yeah. Yay, there we go. Cool. That's right, hardcore. I know it. I know it. Oh, what? Oh. Oh man. Yes, I'm trying to use the force. Wave my hand. Oh. I know. Oh, man. Wait a minute, did it cancel it? Triggering dialogue, home 1A, canceling all dialogue. Canceling all dialogue, canceling all dialogue. No, it doesn't ever trigger that dialogue. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna say it with my mind at the bug. Yeah, I have to make the code believe that it will work. I'm gonna make it believe with debugging. My tried and true workhorse, the debugging process. So really what I want to do is I want to break if the story node and the Z line up. So printf, I am your father. Turn back to the light side of the force. Okay, since I've got this whole story saved, I mean, let's actually save all these. I'm gonna make these story elements for home and home 1A really, really short so we don't have to wait through this every time. Yeah, that'll do. All right, let's make sure this is set up right. So we've got starting at save in 0, 0, no sword, no story elements. Ah. No breakpoint? Oh, what? Why no breakpoint? Oh, because I didn't send one. It's one of those days, I'm telling you. Man, I shouldn't even be coding today. Just driving myself up the wall. Still no breakpoint? I'm about to break something. All right, well, if we, once again, if we start at negative 10, it does trigger. But if we walk down to negative 10, it doesn't. Why is that? Okay, let's turn that breakpoint off. We'll turn this breakpoint on. Try and figure it out. Oh, good night, Marza. Right. Nice, man. All right. Here we got a breakpoint where it's in here, and we'll figure out why it's not getting the next breakpoint. The next breakpoint should work. In fact, we'll set a breakpoint right there. Now I'm going to step through and figure out what in all this nonsense is going on to cause it to not get to this. Oh, the timer? There's a timer right now? Why is there a timer? 21 seconds of timer? Oh, duh. Okay, if we cancel any dialogue, we gotta reset the story timer. Story timer equals zero. Oh, please, I hope this is what it is. Yeah, TextMate for sure, man. I'm also checking out Adam. I think Adam's a pretty good one, too. Yeah, it's not too scary, man. C++ is actually pretty awesome. It's like it's a lot like driving a stick shift or a manual transmission car versus driving an automatic car. You're probably like, what's an automatic car? Because you're from Europe. But yeah, in there in the States, we got all these you know, automatic cars where you can't really, you don't have as much control over the car and the engine. Same thing with C++. You can do so much more. There's so much more power, but it comes at the expense of you having to be a little bit more in control, a little bit more manually controlling everything. What's up, Caviar? Oh, okay. I haven't tried it yet. Okay, come on. Is this going to work this time? Last time we had a timer. That would have killed it all. Okay, we have zero timer this time. It's going to skip over that. Good. Actually, let's run into the next breakpoint. See if we can get to that. Yeah! Oh my god. I think that was all it was. Okay, so it was just that there was so much dialogue already queued up that the cancel all dialogue thing hadn't turned off the timer for that. And that's why it wasn't working. So there's still some dialogue queued up. I'm going in here. Yes! Oh, it's about time. Oh my god, I've been working on this like the whole stream, right? Just as like one little bug practically. Oh, it's about time. Man, I think I'm gonna call it a day here. I mean, call it a moment. I'll get back to coding later on, but dude, I'm done for now. What's happening there? Did it crash? Cool, at least he did his other dialogue though. And then it should play this thing. We should hear some music. Yeah, there's music playing. All right, cool. And if I go to the next screen, we should still have music. Yeah, okay. So let me take some notes here. That's really awesome that all that worked. But there's a couple more issues. One, there's a pause. It's like a complete pause. I've never seen the game do that before. Complete pause after picking up the sword, and then two would be to get. The evil awakening scene to run off of story system. And also, eh. That's basically it. Oh, you got him? Oh, okay. Right? No, I'm never going to blame the chat. You guys are awesome. Yeah, I know. Yeah, tomorrow I should just do art, huh? I got all these bugs I got to finish for the upcoming release this month, the alpha release. So I do got to get do some bug stuff, but maybe I can at least work in some art during the live stream, because man, I've been doing too much code. But yeah, that's it for today's stream. I definitely gotta get some rest and just take a break. I'm like, my head's spinning from all this like debugging here, but at least it works. It's freaking awesome. All right. So, all right, you guys, I'm going to be back tomorrow. Let's see. You know, usually I start streaming between 2 and 4 p.m. Pacific time, whatever that is for your time. So, yeah, that's it for today's stream, and I'll be back tomorrow. Thanks for making me laugh.